Hello everyone, in this video we have one quadrilateral. This length is given 2 root 7, and here is given 10 units. This length is given 6, and then these two side lengths are given as equal. Here is 90 degrees, and angle alpha is asked. Okay. First step, let's call here beta and here theta. Notice that beta plus theta equal 90 degrees, right? I want to create two congruent triangles. Why? Notice that these two lengths are equal. So if you draw a perpendicular line like this, notice that this angle must be equal beta, right? So if we extend corner D like this, and let's draw one more perpendicular line like this. Let's call here point K, and here let's call point T. If you focus on this triangle, if it is beta, this angle must be equal theta, right? That means this triangle and this triangle are congruent, right? Why? Because notice that these two triangles have same angles and opposite sides of the 90 degrees are equal. So triangle BKC and triangle CTA are congruent, right? You know that congruent triangles have same sides and angles. So let's call here M. If there's an M unit opposite side of the beta, opposite side of the beta must be equal M unit. And let's call here H. If there's an H unit opposite side of the theta, opposite side of the theta must be equal H unit. Therefore, H minus 6 left here. And here is 6 minus M. After that, for this triangle, if we apply Pythagorean theorem, we get M squared plus H minus 6 whole squared equal 2 root 7 whole squared. Therefore, M squared plus H squared minus 12H plus 36 equal 28. Likewise, for this triangle, if we apply Pythagorean theorem, we get 6 minus M whole squared plus H squared equal 10 squared. Therefore, 36 minus 12m plus m squared plus h squared equal 100. Therefore, if you multiply the first equation by minus, notice that the signs of these terms will change. After that, if we add these two equations together, minus m squared and positive m squared, these are again, and these are also again. So 12h minus 12m equal 100 minus 28. So 12 times in parentheses h minus m equal 72. If you simplify the expression, that means h minus m equals 6. So h minus 6 is going to be m units, right? That's right here, h minus 6 equal m. Notice that we get an isosceles right triangle. So here must be equal 45 degrees. We know that straight angles equals 180 degrees. So 45 plus alpha equal 180 degrees. Therefore, alpha is going to be 135 degrees. Okay. This was the first method. Now we will calculate value of alpha using second method. This time, let's call here theta and here beta. Alpha plus beta equal 90 degrees, right? After that, if you move this triangle outside of the quadrilateral, like this, so here is theta, here is alpha, and this length is 2 root 7, and here is 6 units. So this triangle and this triangle are congruent. Next step, theta plus beta equal 90 degrees, right? So if we connect these two corners, let's call here point P. After that, if you focus on this triangle is an isosceles right triangle. Therefore, these angles must be equal 45 degrees. Then, if there's a 6 units opposite side of the 45 degrees, opposite side of the 90 degrees must be equal 6 root 2. After that, if you focus on triangle ADP, this triangle is a right triangle. Why? Notice that 2 root 7 whole squared plus 6 root 2 whole squared equal 10 squared. So 28 plus 72 equals 10 squared. So 100 equals 100. That means angle APD is 90 degrees. So alpha equal 45 plus 90 degrees. Therefore, alpha is going to be 135 degrees. Thanks for watching. If you want more videos like this, please don't forget to like and subscribe my channel. Take care and bye-bye.